I don't think we're gonna see any redesigns for the Charger and the Challenger. Oh, see, here we go. Every time I do a video, people wanna cut me off, man. Here we go. Family, what is happening, man? Welcome back to the channel. And before I even get into the video, man, I got a little space, so let's do a little quick pull. Let's start it off. Let's get it off right. Yes, sir. Of course. That's how you start off a video right there, man. I should let the windows down so y'all can get the whole effect of everything. So, man, like I said, welcome to the video, man. Welcome to the channel. For my new viewers, man, so what are y'all gonna get on this channel, man? I'm gonna talk about car news, some of the hot button topics, man. I'm gonna hit up some car meets, get some racing action for y'all. I need to get some more racing action for you guys. Gonna do car mods, gonna give you some car mod reviews. That's what you can expect on this channel, man. If you're into that type of stuff, man, go ahead and just lock it in, man. It's free. So that way you can, you know, stay up to date on all the new videos and hit that notification bell, man. That's gonna help out your boy and help you out as well. So that way you'll know when the videos are dropping and you can tune in as soon as it drops, man. So that's what you can expect from this channel. For all my returning viewers, I wanna appreciate you guys rocking with your boy, tuning in, tapping in with me, commenting, liking, sharing the videos out, man. I really appreciate the support, man. We never thought we'd be here at this point, but here we are, we're here at this point, man, and we're keeping this thing moving and grooving, man. All 2020, well, no longer 2020, all 2021, man. So let's go ahead and get into the topic of today's video. Oh, whoa, a little bumpy. See the title, you see the thumbnail, no clickbait or cap, man. I'm not gonna lie to you, man. I'm gonna bring you exactly what I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna bring you, man. So I've seen a lot of people talk about this. I've seen a lot of news articles about this, and I want to get my spin on what is going on. I want to talk about the future of Dodge, man. There's been several articles being that have came out about what's going on. First thing that people are talking about is the whole SRT team being dismantled and put onto other projects within the company. That is a big thing, because if you know it Dodge, or if you don't, SRT is responsible for all the top of the line stuff that comes out within Dodge, or actually the whole FCA company, man. We're talking, they give you your Hellcats, your Trackhawks, all the big name stuff, all the cars that everyone is after, SRT is responsible for, and they stand for Street and Racing Technology. So, you know, when they put their hands on something, what they're gonna put out is gonna be it's gonna be crazy. Another thing, another article that came out not too long ago is the fact that, you know, a member from Dodge said, like, the V8 days are numbered. Like by 2025, Hemis and stuff that we have now, Hellcats, your Scat Packs, things like that could be a thing of a past. Could be the thing of a past, man. Could be just like, no more. Could be gone. By the way, it's a dinosaur, you feel me? So that's pretty earth-shattering if you are a fan of these big V8s, man. Especially, I mean, not only with just Dodge, but a lot of companies are going that route soon. We all knew it was gonna happen, but the thing about it is we did not know when it was going to happen. Personally, I didn't feel like 2025 it was gonna happen then. I felt like we had some more years, but 2025 is right around the corner. Like, it is right, like, there. It's like a few years away, man. Like, I know a lot of us anticipated this not happening in our lifetime or later on in our lifetime. Big horsepower wars is gonna come to an end, man. And it's gonna suck, man. I know the future is electric, and I know those cars can be faster than a combustion engine, but nothing beats like the feel and sound of a V8. Or I go say V6, I'm not gonna leave you guys out of it. Or any car that makes noise, man. Like, it's one thing for your car to go fast, but for you to feel it is another aspect of it. Like these cars that's cammed out that you hear at car shows and things like that, or seeing videos and all that. Like, people love that. People like that. I'm one of those people. I like that and love that as well. Like, the electric cars, I have much respect for those cars because they can perform crazy. Tesla is doing their thing when it comes to the electric cars, but the Tesla is going to be the wave for the future. everyone's going to be going that route, man, and it's just going to happen, and we're going to get used to it. But I want to speak on a few things, what that exactly means for Dodge. Like, what can we see with these cars, what we're not going to see, and all that. So let's go ahead and get into it. So the first things first, man, like I said, 2025 is kind of the date when things are supposed to be shifting towards, you know, the hybrid and electric realm of things. So, and you can see that shift already happening within FCA, which is, you know, kind of the scaling, so whatever you want to call it. The Jeep Wrangler is coming out with a hybrid. The Jeep Wrangler is going to be a hybrid. That's crazy, right? And Chevy's already going that route. They're supposed to be coming out with a C8 that's going to be a hybrid, which, you know, that's crazy. They're taking their top supercar, their top sports car, and making it a hybrid. Ford has already went that direction with their Mustang Mach-E, pretty much making an SUV, pretty much making their Mustang that we all grown to know and love and Dodge at car shows. That's a joke, so don't get mad at me. I'm just joking here. And they're making that an electric hybrid SUV. That is wild. Oh no, I don't think it's hybrid. I might be full electric. I can't remember. I think it's either hybrid or full electric. I think it's gonna be full electric. And there's a lot of other cars that are full electric or hybrids, right? So that right there is laying the brick, so to speak, of these cars that we know and love with these V8s and stuff are going to the hybrid route, right? I know we all make fun of them, but that's the future. The hybrid is the future. The full electric cars are the future. Now, another thing here, I know I mentioned the SRT team, that's with Dodge. It has been torn apart and put on other things within the company. Now, what do I actually think this means? Or actually what this part of stuff they said. There will still be SRT vehicles, but it's just the team itself has been put on other things. So what they're going to be looking to do in the future is put some of that SRT technology in some of the other vehicles. If you know, like I know, the SRT, here we go. Every time I do a video, people want to cut me off, man. Here we go. We're about to start this stuff already. But anyway, the SRT team, like, they do like some crazy things with the cars. They are out to make cars perform at the highest level possible and do whatever it takes to make those cars do it, from brakes, suspension, horsepower, all that stuff. So they're taking those people and putting them on everything in the company. So what I foresee happening is that the other cars under Stellantis, I think I'm saying it right, let's look for those cars to be more performance cars, gonna be better quality. That's what I think we're gonna see here. Hopefully don't prove me wrong here, but I think we're gonna see better quality cars across the board among all the other brands. Cause Stellantis is just not FCA. I think there's like Fiat and all the other stuff. It's gonna be better quality across the boards. Now here's the biggest thing here, man. Since these cars are probably going to go electric 2025, and I made several videos on this talking about what's coming for Dodge, talking about redesigns and things like that. With that news that hybrids are coming, I don't think we're going to see any redesigns for the Charger and the Challenger until the hybrid models start coming out. So what we see now from the Chargers and Challengers are pretty much what the car is going to look like for the next few years. I know that sucks, because we're definitely like looking for something new and something different with the cars, because they had this body style and chassis for quite some time. You know, I don't see Dodge going in and spending money trying to redesign a car just to flip around and have to redesign it again for the hybrid. So I'm thinking 2025 is when we could start seeing changes with the cars. Now, there may be small changes Dodge can make, sort like the Durango. The Durango technically is a new model, far as like some redesigns they did with it, but it's very small redesigns, like a new bumper on the front. They dropped the Hellcat engine, which they already had. So nothing brand new has been developed from Dodge, like nothing out of the wall left field that they had to go in the lab and research and develop from scratch. The last great car that Dodge, when I mean great, I mean the car that was built from the ground up, started from scratch, is gonna be the Demon. New engine, whole different, like, granted same chassis, but in the same look, but a lot of different things went into this car that a lot of other cars did not have at the time. We're not gonna see major overhauls. We're gonna see small things here and there, but major overhauls are not gonna happen until 2025 at the earliest. So we're gonna have to get used to seeing these cars. Another thing is, what does that actually mean, man? I mean, if the cars aren't gonna be redesigned, I don't foresee any new engines coming out, man. The 5.7s, I know people been hollering that they need more power. The Scat Packs, I know people saying they need more power. And some things people wanted to see in the Hellcats, but unfortunately, we're not gonna see that. The 5.7 is gonna be the 5.7 we see now until it's over. The 6.4s that we have now are going to be what they are into the over. No horsepower changes are coming. They're not going to put that time into doing that. The Hellcat engines, who knows what they're going to do with those, but I don't foresee any big changes coming with the Hellcat engines either, if they do anything, you know. So what we got is what we got, and we're going to deal with it, unfortunately. Okay, what will the next generation of dogs look like? Of course, we're going to be looking at hybrids, possibly V6s. Maybe the only model that has a V8 is the SRT, and the V8 be a smaller V8. They did say, the SRT engineers did say, like, that the Hellcats and the big supercharged V8 is going to be no more. But they did say that the performance will still be there. They said the cars are still going to be able to do big burnouts and things like that. I mean, electric cars can do burnouts. It's going to sound different and look different, but they can still do burnouts. They're still going to make fast cars. We're not going to see the big 800 horsepower cars come out anymore. We're not going to see 900 horsepower cars come out. We're not going to see that, unfortunately. With all that being said, I got a question for my viewers out there. If Dodge goes this route, are you still sticking with Dodge? I know a lot of people attracted to Dodge because of the fact of the horsepower these cars be putting out for the price they put them out at. Will that change force you to go elsewhere? Are you still going to stick with Dodge? Personally, just being, you know, just from my standpoint and how I view it, I think I would still stick with Dodge, but honestly, I'm going to have to see what these cars are going to be looking like. I mean, they could go hybrid. But how would they look? How would they perform? I'm definitely interested to see that part. Is it now the time to go ahead and get yourself into an SRT, get yourself into a Scat Pack or something like that while the car is still being produced? Like, do you want to wait and see what it looks like, or go ahead and get into one now and make your decision from there? Personally, I think now is the time. Now, between now and 2025, is the time to go ahead and jump into that car you want to get that has that big V8. Because you don't know what's going to happen with these cars. They legit could be the last run of Scat Packs and Hellcats and the 5.7s, like in 2024. That could be it. 2025, that could be really limited or be priced to a point where it's going to be hard to own one. If you pay attention to, like, buying these cars, like, these cars have, like, a gas guzzler tax attached to them, meaning if you buy this car, you got to pay an extra couple thousand dollars on top of it because of the engine that's in the car, especially with the Hellcats. I forgot what that gas guzzler tax is, but they're gonna make you pay extra for that car. Like, okay, you want this big V8, you're gonna have to pay the tax on it. There's a lot of different directions it can go, and I'm very interested to see what is going to happen, man. So comment down below. I want to hear from you guys. Are you going to stick with Dodge if you have one, knowing that things are going to change? Are you going to go ahead and upgrade your car, or are you going to hold out and see what the future holds? Let me know, man. I want to hear from you guys. As always, thank you for tuning in. Catch you on the next one. We are out. Cut it.